On October 14th, Saab received an order from the Swedish Defence Materiel Administration, or FMV, regarding continued conceptual studies for future fighter systems. While it's exciting to see countries thinking ahead and planning the next generation of fighter aircraft, there's not too much to say at this point. Nonetheless, we take a look at what is known about the program in today's video. So, yes, it was in mid-October that Sweden's FMV signed a deal with its homegrown defense contractor Saab to continue studies for future fighter systems. The order value amounts to approximately 2.6 billion Swedish krona, equivalent to roughly 237.36 million euros. The contract period is 2025 to 2027. Saab states that the order includes conceptual studies of manned and unmanned solutions in a quote-unquote system of systems perspective, as well as technology development and demonstrators. Saab says that it will continue to collaborate closely with FMV as well as the Swedish Armed Forces, the Swedish Defence Research Agency, GKN Aerospace and other industry partners to complete its study. The order is actually an extension and expansion of the original contract signed in March 2024. Back then, the head of Saab's aeronautics business stated that the company was in a strong position due to recently developing the Gripen E and Global Eye. This has resulted in the company developing advanced technology and the engineering know-how to take the future fighter concept forward. Saab also said in 2024 that it would be exploring innovation platforms, including the Swedish government's Defence Innovation Initiative and NATO's Defence Innovation Accelerator for the North Atlantic. The concept studies included in that 2024 contract took place in parallel with Saab upgrading Gripen C/D and introducing Gripen E in Sweden and Brazil. There's not too much more that is known, although the website TWZ, The War Zone, reported in December 2024 that Saab had presented concepts for a potential new generation crewed fighter and a series of drones intended to work alongside it. The future concepts appeared in a TV segment aired on Sweden's SVT channel and were discussed by Petter Nilsson, head of Saab's advanced programs. Screenshots from the broadcast were shared on social media by the Swedish military blogger at Gripen News, and you can see them here. The screen capture shows what is titled the Saab F-Series, with the subheading Same Brain in Different Bodies. From left to right, it consists of a crewed future fighter, a subsonic uncrewed platform with a weight of no more than 5 tons, the existing Gripen E crewed multi-role fighter, a supersonic uncrewed platform with a weight of more than 5 tons, and a low-cost subsonic uncrewed platform with a weight of less than 1 ton. Thus, it seems like Saab's proposed successor in the Saab F-Series is presented as a crewed future fighter, a jet tailored for high speed as well as low observability. The concept features a sleek, blended wing-slash-body configuration. As TWZ notes, the swept wings are cropped, and the fuselage appears to have area rule optimization for supersonic efficiency. The empennage looks like it consists of outward canted stabilizers, though it is unclear if it includes vertical tails as well. Some of the same features found in the crewed future fighter concept, notably the overall blended wing/body and cropped wings, appear in the supersonic uncrewed platform, although this is shown as being somewhat smaller and it lacks any kind of tail surfaces. It's a sleek, sharp, and thin aircraft, which TWZ highlights has a prominent bulge roughly above where the engine nozzle would be, the function of which isn't immediately clear. An underside view hints at significant internal capacity for fuel and internal stores, although no details of the weapons bay are visible. And then there's the lighter subsonic uncrewed platform, known to be much closer in appearance to a typical fifth-generation crewed fighter like the US F-35. It has relatively small delta wings and outward-canted vertical fins. The SVT television feature also noted that Saab has a goal of replacing the Gripen within the next 25 years, or around 2050. There's quite a bit more information in that Warzone article, and we'd rather not regurgitate all of its information for our video, so we'll be sure to leave a link to the piece in the video description. The bottom line is that it's still early days for Saab and its development of a future fighter, or a family of combat aircraft, both crewed and uncrewed. So, over the next few years, we'll have to be on the lookout for more designs and details regarding this exciting long-term project. But what do you think of Sweden's push to develop future fighter aircraft? Let us know by leaving a comment.